Yo, what is up, everyone? It is the Beast. Welcome back to the Beast On. It's been a while, hasn't it? Things have escalated quite seriously since my last video, which was with the amazing Dr. Lon Payenson, emergency room doctor with the Memorial Healthcare System, and also operates Doctors on Call 365, and doing telehealth now. So if you have an issue, you can always go to doctorsoncall365.com. And you'll get a telehealth appointment. So that's good. Man, I don't know when that last video was, but just think about it. That was just when this thing was starting in this country, when the coronavirus was just starting to spread. And it's gotten out of control. And, you know, what bothers me, I think, the most is just the bungling, like the people that don't pay attention and read and go to the right sources for news just have no idea what is going on in this country. I'm an info junkie, I'm a news junkie, I'm a current events junkie, I'm a facts junkie, I have a curiosity level. I've always been like that. I can't be anywhere without my tweet deck being up or Twitter being up or something. I need info all the time about various things, whether it's coronavirus or the stock market or news or international events or sports. I just need info. I need it all the time. And I've always been like that. Hell, I remember back in the day in sixth grade, in Mr. Deziak's language arts class at the lovely Linfield Middle School, he would give, and this was in the 80s, let's see, that would have been 88, 87, 88, around then, he would give extra credit for current events knowledge. And every morning, even before he started doing this, I would say starting in early on, man, it started out with just like my dad leaving me the sports page. My dad would go to work at 5 a.m. and leave me the sports page to read, even before I could really read, just to look at the standings and the numbers and what have you. And then after that, I just started reading the paper every morning and watching the local news and getting up early and just knowing what was going on in the world. I used to watch the nightly news with Tom Brokaw and all of that stuff. I was just always into needing information. So I think the biggest thing that bothers me is people that don't have the same hunger for information like I do, but also that aren't getting the information or going to the wrong places for it. If I see one more person tell me this is the flu, I'm going to come to your house and flog you. If I see one more person tell me, "Oh, no, no, it's good, it's good. I'm like only 30, so it's not going to bother me." Wrong. If I see one more person saying, "Oh, it's cool, man, it's cool. If I go out and have a drink or if I go to the beach, it's fine because I'm not in the demo." Yeah, no. Here's what we've learned is that if you look at every single graph that is put out by all of the most reliable scientific sources, we are on the same track as Italy. The curves are the exact same, except we're 2 weeks behind them. Coughed into my elbow. Of course, my own hypochondriac nature has not helped the fact that I've had a cold for like 10 days. That I can't get rid of, but I've had no fever and no lower respiratory symptoms, and I was contemplated for this video just bringing up every one of my medical devices I have in the house, just so you could see of what a nut job I am. The multiple thermometers, oral, temporal, ear. Thank you. The Exergen temporal scanner, man, that gets it done. It's good stuff. I just ordered my Zinsa Oh no, Kensa. Sorry, I just ordered my Kensa thermometer, which syncs up with your phone, and that helps them track where fevers are, which kind of helps them track where the virus is. Go look into that company, Kensa. They're on the cutting edge of it. Go get yourself a Kensa thermometer if you can. If you can find them. I don't even want to know where I found mine and overpaid for it. But basically what it is a thermometer that links up with your phone. And a lot of you would be like, well, I don't want to share this information. I get you. But in this, like, we're in a special time. And so this thermometer, you take your temperature, it syncs with your phone, but then the information goes to the company, and geographically they can know where fevers are spiking by people taking their temperature. And therefore, they're ahead of the curve of the CDC and other places on where this virus is, because they can track where temperatures are spiking. And that's a pretty good indicator of where this virus is. So I've got that going on. And then I've got my pulse oximeter, which is the thing that goes on your finger and it gives you your pulse and your blood oxygen level. So I've been doing that 28 times a day. Mine's up there, you know, 97, 98. I'm never going to get to the 99 or 100 because I've got a lot of this going on, which hinders my ability to have oxygen capacity. But I'm in the clear on that. I've got my blood pressure monitor. I've got an EKG monitor that attaches to my phone. And of course, I have an endoscopic otoscope in case I need to look in my ears or any other orifices. Because I'm a hypochondriac. So I feel pretty good about my own health despite having this cold, which is okay. My throat's on fire though. And I hate to say this, I don't want to, whatever. Part of me hopes that this, you know, meaningless cold I've had for 11 days is actually some mild form of the coronavirus, because then I would have gotten through it without the worst of the worst, and I'd have maybe some immunity to it. But that's neither here nor there. That's my weird thinking. So back to information. What we're about to see happen in New York City, what we're about to see happen in several places in this country is going to be out of control. And what is disconcerting, and this is completely apolitical, because in this time of what is a national emergency, I feel like we all need to be on the same page. So this is not political, but the leadership we've seen from the federal government is a shit show, just to be honest with you. And I know the president holds these daily news briefings at 11:30, and everything sounds hunky-dory, and this medicine's becoming available, and this is the, and there's thousands of, there's so many untruths being told that the American public is just being led into like a brick wall of nonsensical untruths. All of these masks that Mike Pence talked about being available, he didn't quite tell you that really it's gonna take 18 months to get these millions of masks out. Well, in 18 months, I mean, how many thousands of people are gonna be dead? It's not gonna be enough. The ventilators, like the federal government keeps seeming to want to pass the buck to state governments and local governments. And I understand that's kind of how our system is supposed to work. But in a time of crisis, I expect more from the federal government. The federal government, believe it or not, whether you trust it or not, or you believe in, you know, if you're a Grover Norquist fan and you want a government the size of a thimble, or you're a Bernie fan and you want a huge, massive government, here's what I know about the federal government. When it comes to big operations, they can get things done. Just look at the way our military runs, right? The way we can move things, the way we can build things, the way we can show up at a place at a moment's notice and get something done. We do it better than anyone else in the world, and it's done through our federal government. It's not our state governments, it's not our local governments, it is the federal government using all of its resources to their capability, which gets things done. And I think that's the route we need to go. I think it needs to be here. Listen, I don't care what Unit A of the Air Force or Navy or Army or Marines or Coast Guard or what have you are doing at this moment. Yes, keep us safe. Make sure we have enough troops to keep us safe. But it all needs to just be mobilized to help us fight this crisis. Because we're going to get to the point really soon where our ability to react to this crisis on a local level is going to be overrun. I know emergency room doctors all over this country that I've talked to, and we're already pushing the point where there's no ICU beds. And we're already pushing the point where there's no ventilators. And we're already pushing the point, I shit you not, where there are hospitals that are setting up shifts of nurses, like when they're not on, to sew their own masks and gowns. Like literally there's sewing machines being put in hospitals so they can come up with this stuff. That is not a lie. That is firsthand knowledge. If that's where we are, I mean, think about that for a second. We are the richest country in the world. We are the most modern country in this world. We get shit done better than anybody. And right now there are nurses at hospitals sewing their own masks because we don't have enough. And I really don't care. I mean, yes, this has been a problem that has obviously been one that's been a long time in the making, but it's how it's being dealt with now that is just disconcerting. Like, what a bad look. You mean to tell me in this country of the best doctors, the best hospitals, the best research, the best scientists, we have nurses sitting in their break room on sewing machines, sewing their own masks? That really says everything you need to know about the federal response to this. It's been unacceptable. But here's the message I really want to get by. One, and this is really important. By the way, you hear my dogs barking downstairs, and we have two now. We adopted Marley, basically because his name was Marley, and I love Bob Marley. It just turns out he's a cute, cuddly dog, but it wouldn't have mattered. He could have been the ugliest thing on earth. His name is Marley. We were going to rescue him. But so now we have Marley and Charlie. That gets weird. So the other day, I'm just sitting on my couch. All of a sudden, I'm on Instagram. I almost never check my DMs on Instagram, but I noticed I had one. And it was a former coworker from the radio business who just wanted to know how I was doing. And it like almost brought me to tears because it's like, man, someone cares. Like, they know that, you know, it's been a tough time since I was let go by the radio stations. They know that my wife is a cancer survivor and has a really compromised immune system. They know that my son almost died of respiratory failure when he was one. He was on a ventilator for days to keep him alive. He was struck by an unknown virus. They could never figure out what virus it was that put him close to death. So we've been through this as a family before. And my wife and my kid are in the, you know, top of the top percentage of people that need to be really safe and away from this virus. Myself with my own underlying conditions and obviously my years of treating my body like shit probably don't put me in a good class of people either. But just to know that someone reached out to ask how I was doing, how I was handling it, you know, am I gonna have a job? That meant the world to me. Just someone reaching out. How are you? And it's been happening more and I love it. And I think that's what we need to be doing. Like, there's a lot of bad stuff going on and it's going to get worse, people. Like, I don't want to alarm you, but I mean, every single, like, I spend all day reading the research, the data, the science, just digging into the hard numbers by the world's foremost experts from so many countries. And I know that, you know, that part of the president's job and the vice president, everybody is to reassure the American people that we're gonna be okay, and I get that. But the truth is a lot of us aren't gonna be okay. This is not gonna just disappear. This is not going away. It's not going away anytime soon. Cases may stem in the middle of the summer, but it's going to come back in the fall. Until we have a widespread vaccine, and antivirals that that definitely work. Like, this is not stopping. And then you wonder, how long can we really sustain self-quarantining? I know that there's, you know, going to be close to $2 trillion that are going to be pumped into the American economy by the government, whether it's helping small businesses, helping individuals, helping big companies, and holy shit, fuck you, big companies, if you're going to do the stock buyback thing. Not going to mention any names, former company I used to work for that it seemed like that dude and his dad kept buying back stock. How's that worked out for you? But yeah, it's going to get worse before it gets better. So just check on each other every day. Check on someone. See how they're doing. Mental health is going to play a huge part of this. And we need to check on each other. Check on me. See how I'm doing. Reach out to me. I'll reach out to you. Yeah, we need to, we may have to do social distancing from a physical standpoint, but we don't have to do it from an actual social standpoint. We can be in touch with one another. So thank you to that coworker that reached out to me. It really touched me. I want to give another thanks. So as a lot of you know, I now work for a company called Code Ninjas. We teach coding to kids 7 to 14 years of age, actually 5 to 14. We have a junior program. And we were going to keep it going as long as we could. And that was the intention. But obviously, things have changed. And having a bunch of kids in a center coding is not a good idea. So our amazing owners, Tracy and Eric Leon, and they really are amazing, just amazing people. Tracy's just a bundle of energy and positivity and just everything you want. And Eric is just a stud who is smart as hell and a coder himself and just is all about it, man. I love them both. And we're going virtual. So starting Monday, we're going to have virtual programs for kids that want to have something else to do, another activity besides just their homework or their virtual learning or going out back and, you know, running around. And for me, that's great. It's not full time. It's going to be 3 days a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday. It doesn't pay all the bills, but I'm more fortunate than a lot of people in small businesses who lost jobs. Yeah, I mean, my dad's had to shut things down for a while now, with his company, and that affects everything. So, it's just the nature of the economy, but I am so blessed that I work for people that want to try to give this a go, and at least keep us employed 3 days a week, if not more, so that we can help out this community. We have dojos in Cooper City, in Coral Springs, Plantation, building one in Weston. We'll see how that's going. But if it's a virtual program, you can do it from anywhere. So be on the lookout for that. Parents, if you're looking for something for your kids, maybe it's an option. I'm not trying to sell anything right now. I'm just letting you know it's going to be out there. I know I'm just going on and joining on. Really, this is about me just having a vent and wanting you to know to take this seriously. I saw the president absolutely destroy Peter Alexander from NBC on national TV at a press conference, and it's stupid. The question was valid, which is, how are you going to reassure the American people? I think that's what we need right now is reassurance and strong leadership. And then the president just is like, you know, get the hell out of here with that question. And, you know, you suck, Peter Alexander, and whatever. Like, I don't know how that helps in this situation, but that's neither here nor there. We can deal with that in November if you want to or not, depending on your mood. I just think right now we need to be unified. But most importantly, one, we need to check on each other, and two, we need the federal government to freaking help. I know Ron DeSantis has got the National Guard down here, and we've got testing centers, and that's great. But I mean, the federal government can do this better than anyone. They know about supply chains. They know about logistics. They know about moving stuff really fast. The president's like, "Hey, we're not in the business of shipping." Dude, have you ever heard of something called the United States Postal Service? I don't know if you're familiar with that, but they can move shit, and you own it. It's a federal service. Just saying. All right. I know this isn't the most entertaining or informative thing for me, but for the first video back, I just needed to vent for a few. We're all doing fine. We're home. We're taking daily walks. We're walking the dogs. We're trying to cook at home. We're trying to come up with some new stuff. We're watching new movies. We're enjoying each other's company as a family. It's going to get old, I'm sure. But for right now, we're all good. I hope you're all good. Listen, please do me a favor. Pass this on. And all I want from this video right now is for you to put in the chat below, in the comments, how you're doing. Are you doing okay? Let me know. If you need someone to talk to, I'm here for you. Literally, seriously. I don't care if I don't know you. I don't care if you're a stranger from Bangladesh. You can slide into my DMs on the Insta or the Twitter at Miami Radio Beast. And let's talk. Let's have a conversation. If you need someone to talk to, I'm here for you. If I need someone to talk to, I'll definitely find one of you. So that'll do it for me. I know, listen, hopefully as we get further into this, I'll have more videos that you'll want to watch. I'm hoping to do a bunch of Skype sessions with not only doctors, but just other people around this whole situation. And then, of course, right now I'm going to get Little Beast from downstairs and we'll switch focus and go do a video on Tom Brady being on the Bucks, because that's what we got to do. That's going to help him with his life, being able to rant on Tom Brady. So we'll do that. But thank you all for watching. Subscribe and hit the bell so you know when there's a new video. And hopefully the next time we do this, it's a little more focused and better. But I love you all. Peace. See you when I see you.